Welcome to the Programming Guide channel. This is Bhargavi. First of all, I would like to tell you all my viewers and subscribers belated Happy Sankranti. Okay, now today we are going to discuss the most important topic for the academics as well as for the interviews in the C language, that is call by value and call by reference. So this call by value and call by reference combines the things which are related to the functions as well as the pointers. So before that, we need to understand what is mean by pointer, what is mean by function. In my last videos, I already explained you what is function, how to write a function, how to call a function, how to declare a function, what is a function declaration, what is a return type, everything I discussed in the last video. Clear? And in the before to that video also I have discussed about the pointers, okay, how to declare the pointer, how to use the pointers in order to print the value. Okay, today in this program, in this video, we are going to discuss about the call by value and call by reference. Actually, what is mean by call by value and call by reference? Reference is nothing but address. Value is nothing but the data which is storing in the memory block. So call by value means we are passing, for example, I have 10 in a memory location. I'm passing the 10 to some other functions to perform the calculations over that. Call by reference means I'm passing the address of the memory location where the 10 is stored. Clear? So 10 is passed in the call by value, whereas address is passed in the call by reference. Now we'll see clearly what is mean by call by value and call by reference. Okay, now calling function. Before entering into the subject, first we need to understand what is calling function and what is called a function. Now when we are writing a function, we are writing calling a function. So this is a statement: a function which is calling another function is called calling function. Now sum a comma b, already we have seen how to declare this function. Now I'm calling which function? Sum a comma b. That means this is a function, is going to be called, and to that function we are passing the value of a and the value of b. So here a comma b are called as actual variables. Now what is mean by called function? A function which is called by another function. That means when you call sum a comma b, so which function is going to be executed? This function is going to be executed. So we say that this is a calling function, this is the called function. Now whatever the data we have in a, that is getting copied to x. Whatever the data we have in b, that is getting copied to y. Now here this x comma y are formal variables. This a comma b are actual variables. Now what is the difference between formal variables and actual variables? The formal variables here a comma b are actual. That means, for example, I want to store 10. I want to store 20. Right? So this 10 is a, this is 10 is 20 is b. So where you declare this function? We declare this function normally in main function of the C program. So here this a comma b are related to the original values, and those are work in the main function only. So these a and b are actual to this main function only. So that means, so this AB will be work in the main function, whereas this X comma Y will work only within the sum function. So this called as a formal variables, whereas A comma B are called as the actual variables. Understood? So clear, you need to have a clear thing here. What is calling function? What is called function? So when you write this type of statement, this is calling function. When you define the function body, that we call it as a called function. Clear? If you understand these two things, then only you will be clear with the next concepts. Now first we see call by value method. So the call by value method of passing the arguments to a function. So understood clearly, call by value method of passing arguments to a function copies the actual value of an argument into formal parameter of the function. So what they are saying, so the value of A and the value of B R gets copied. That means, so this A is copied to X, so this A value is copied to X and the Y value is copied to, sorry, B value is copied to Y. That means consider A is 10, so B is 20 in the main function. Okay, that means what? Here one more copy of A is created as X, one more copy of B is created as Y. That means same value we are not taking, we are creating other copy. That means already we have a book. If you make it a xerox, what happens? We have two copies. Similarly, we already have a original thing, but what we are doing, we are copying into other variable. So this 10 is available at A as well as at X. So this X and Y, if you are doing any changes to the value of X and value of Y, that does not affect the values of A and B. Why? Because these will work in main function, these two will work in swap function. For example, I want to interchange these two values. So if I interchange X to Y, Y to X, so what your X contains? Your X contains 20, Y contains 10. But what about A and B? His values of A and B are swapped? No, no swapping is done here. Why? Because we are swapping only X and Y, so that the values of X becomes 20, Y becomes 10. But we are not copying, so we are not swapping A and B. So this A and B values does not have any impact of swapping this, right? So we does not have any impact on swapping of these two values. So this is called as call by value. That means when you pass a value, the value is get copied to another variable. So if you are changing any values when you are copied, so the copied content only modified, the original content will not be changed. So this is called as call by value. So in this case, changes made to the parameter inside the function have no effect on the argument. So here parameters are called as X and Y, arguments are A comma B. So in a previous thing, what we are doing, so here A comma B are, here A comma B are arguments, so here X and Y are parameters. So this argument does not have any impact of X and Y. Clear? So this we call it as a call by value. Consider an example. Now here I have a value A, I have a value B. Now A is having 10, B is having 20, and A address is 101, B address is 103. Now I want to interchange two values of A and B, right? So what we call normally swapping, we call it as. Now I am calling a function void swap int X comma Y. Now what we are doing, we are making A copy to X and B copy to Y. That means internally for the value of 10 we are creating a copy, for value of B we are creating a copy. So here the 10 address is 101, here the 10 address is 105. Why? Because we are making a one more copy, not the same copy we are using, we are making one more copy. So 101 105. So here 20 is in 103, I am making one more copy of that, and then that also be stored in 106. So that is Y. Now one more copy of AV is created as X and Y. If you change X comma Y, that does not affect the A comma B, because X and Y are formal to swap function only. That means this X and Y are only works in swap function. So only these two values will be swapped. That does not affect A comma B. Next we see call by reference. So call by reference is slight difference. We have the call by value. So reference means what? Address we are passing. Your reference is nothing but what? So na pair refers A and D. If you have any help, if you need someone help, what we say, take my reference so that you will get easy whatever the work you want to do. So here similarly, reference is nothing but address. We are representing something. Now passing arguments to a function, copy is the address of arguments. So copy is the what? Address of an argument into formal parameter. What it is doing? It is copying address of argument, not argument. It is directly copying address. Don't forget this address. Inside the function, the address is used. Access the actual arguments in the call. Now, the previous example only I am considering. To pass a value by reference, argument pointers are used. So what we are using? Pointers are passed to the functions just like any other value. So accordingly, you need to clear the function parameters as a pointer type. So reference pass just to, we are passing the reference. That means we are passing the address. So the address always to be stored in a pointer variable only, not normal variable. So consider the last example. Here, swap ampersand of A and ampersand of B. That means 101 will be copied in 10 and A, 103 will be 20 and B. Now, what we are passing? We are passing address. Now, what you are passing to the X and Y? Now, your X contains 101 and your Y contains 103. Now, that means your X block and Y block. Now, in this X block, 10, in the Y block, 20 we have. Now what we are passing? We are passing address. So addresses will be stored in only pointer variable. So when you declare the parameters, the two parameters of pointer type only. Now X, observe here, 101 we are getting, 103 we are getting. But in the last call by value, this will be 105, this will be the 107. So only we are taking the same memory location into X, the same location, memory location as Y. So here, if you changes made to the X and Y, that also affect the A and B. Why? Because addresses are same. That means internally what happens to this 10 and 101 location, we are giving two names, A, X. For 20, at the address 103, we are giving two names, B, Y. So AB will be valid in main function, XY will be valid in swap function. So if your changes to the X and Y, if I swap these two values, so what happens? This 10 becomes gone. Your X contains 20. Here the Y contains 10. So what is actually, where are the X and Y? So 101 location 20 is there. 103 location 10 is there. So 101 location, what the value will have? 20. In 103 location we have 10. So that means effect of X and Y will be occurs here also. So this is the difference between call by value and call by reference. So in the call by value, we pass only values. In call by reference, we pass addresses of the values. So here, swap function impact will be on main function also. That means actual variables also modified. In call by value, if you interchange the swap function, so that does not affect the values of actual variables. Now, in next, we'll see differences between call by value and call by reference. The actual arguments can be variable or constant. The actual arguments can only be variable. So in call by value, so we can pass the swap A comma B and swap 10 comma 20 also we can pass. That means direct values also we can pass. But in call by reference, must and should you should pass arguments only. That means ampersand of A, ampersand of B only you can pass. The values of the actual argument are sent to formal argument which are normal variables. So swap A comma B, swap X comma Y. So these are formal variables or normal variables. But whereas in call by reference, actual arguments are sent to the formal argument which are of pointer variables. Here normal variables are used, here pointer variables are used. Any changes made by the formal arguments will not reflect to the actual arguments. Any changes made to the formal arguments will reflect to the actual arguments. So this is related to call by value and call by reference. Next we see the program of call by value and call by reference. But this is the most important when you go for any interviews or for any academic years. So this concept is more and more important. Surely in academics also you will get a question. In interviews also you will get a question on call by value and call by reference. Okay. Right? If you have any things in this, please comment me in the comment section. Next, we'll discuss. Now, we discuss the program on call by value and call by reference. Now, first, we'll do the program on call by value. Now, as usual, first two statements are hash include statements. So, what is the use of hash include statements? So, the statements use is what? So, to include the header files which are related to the printf and scanf main function and clear screen, getch, all those are related to these stdio.h as well as an conivo.h, standard input output header file, console input output header file. Now, this is a main function. Okay, now what the things we need? A comma b, two variables we need. So directly I'm giving the values over here. That means we are initializing the value. So the declaration is different, initialization is different. Initialization is nothing but initially we are providing some values to the value a and b. Now I'm clearing the previous screen. Now first of all we have to write function prototype. That means function declaration we have to specify. So what is our function? I want to interchange two values. So I'm writing the function as swap. So to that values, what you want to pass? We want to pass two variables, right? Swap inter comma inter. So what is the use of declaration of function? That means when if you declare the function in this way, we are specifying that specifying the compiler that we are giving the function in the program. So this is the syntax of the program. So this is a function name. It is not going to return any values and it having two parameters. Clear? So that is the use of function declaration. Now call a function. So calling function, called function, already told you. Now I'm calling a function a comma b, now semicolon. Clear? So in order to understand the output clearly, so before swap, what is the values of a and b, what is the values of a and b after swap, we'll write. So first we'll write before swap. Before swap, a comma b are modulus of d, and next output to be in the next line, comma a comma b. So before swapping, this is the process. This we are going to print. Next, what we have to do? Printf after swap. After swap, a comma b are modulus of d and modulus of d and slash n. I'm writing a comma b values. Clear? So before swapping, what the a values and b values? After swapping, what the a values and b values? Now I'm writing getch and I'm closing it. Right? Now write the swap program. So what is the return type? So void, it is not going to return any values. Next swap. Now what it is accepting? It is accepting two integers, int comma int, we are specifying here. So integer x comma integer y. Now we need a temporary variable. Now I want to interchange two things, x comma y. So with the help of the third variable, I'm interchanging. So I'm declaring a temporary variable. Now first temp is equals to x. That means I'm making a copy of x to temp. Now x is empty now. Now put the value of y into x. Now y is copied to x. Now y is empty. Now y is equals to temp. So I think you understand this. Now first I am copying x to temp. Now x is free. Now into the x, what we are copying? X is equals to y means what? Whatever the value you have in y, that is copied to x. Now y is empty. Now y is equals to temp. So temp in temp, what you have actually x. Now x is gets copied to y. So here y is copied to x and here x is copied to y. So two values are interchanged. Now we print the values in the function. Printf values of x comma y are in swap function. Now modulus of d and modulus of d comma x comma y. Clear? Now compile the program. So what error we have? Oh, I have forgotten to put the semicolon over here. Success. Now run. Now before swap a comma b are 10 and 20. Values of x comma y are in swap function are 20 and 10. After the swap a comma b are 10 and 20. So that means here the values of x comma y are changing to 20 and 10. So that means they are swapped, but a comma b are does not have any impact. Why? Because this is a call by value. So x comma y only changing after swapping also. So it is not supposed to change the values of a and b. So this is call by value. Now trace the program. So tracing is very much important. Why? Because if you trace the program, you'll be very clear. So first printf, before swap a comma b is 10 and 20. Now we are calling a function called swap. So control directly moves to the swap function. Now x comma y, a is 10, b is 20. Now x is 10, y is 20. Now in that we are doing swapping. Now here values of x and y are printed. So what is the value of x? 20. What is the value of y? 10. Why? Because we are changing with the help of the temporary variable. Now after completing of swap function, control moves back to the main function, and from where we are calling the function. Now after swap a comma b. Now clear the output. Clear? Understood? So this is the program related to call by value. Now I'm saving the program. Call value dot c, I'm saving. Okay. Now call by reference means what? So in the same program I'm doing some modification. So call by reference means what? We have to pass the address of a and we have to pass the address of b. Clear? So what you are passing? We are passing the address of a and address of b. So addresses, if you pass, always it should accept by using their values. That means in the last topic I already explained you. So if the if you pass addresses, that to be stored in a pointer variable. So that means the values are gets copied to pointer variable. So here what is your function syntax? Void swap integer pointer variable, integer pointer variable. So here in the definition section also you have to change it to the pointer variable. That means we are informing the compiler that we have a function called swap that is going to accept two pointer values. So here address we are passing. So here we should accept with the help of the pointers only. So this is the difference between call by value and call by reference. Now here what we are changing, you are changing star x star y values, not x comma y. Star x star y are pointer variables. So you should accept, you should change that star x star y values as a pointers only. So normal x is contains what? Address. But star x contains what? Value. So pointer variables are to be changed with the pointer variables only. Clear? So here we should print star x value and star y value. Simple. So if you pass address, the values gets copied to x and y. But here, so the copy of address of a are copied to x and address of b is copied to y. Now compile the program. Success. Now observe the changes here. Now before swap, a is 20, b is, sorry, a is 10, b is 20. After values within the swap function 20 and 10, up to this same output for the call by value and call by the reference. But after swap, a is becoming 20, b is becoming 10. So original values of a and b are affecting here. Now trace the program. Now pressing F7. Now a 10, b 20. Clear the screen. We are printing 10 and 20 as the a b values. Now call the swap function. We are passing address of a and address of b. That is accepted by pointers x and y. So we are interchanging the variables values which are in x and y. So which values we have in x and y? In x we have 10, in y we have 20 as normal to the call by value. But what the address is there? Address of a is copied to x, address of b is copied to y. That means same copy we are taking and we are modifying. Now interchange those two values and print those two values and back. So here the addresses we are passing, that means same copy we are changing. So copy to thing and see the output. Now nothing but what call by value means, we are making a one more Xerox copy. That means one copy we have. If you make one more copy, what happens? If you are modifying the new copy, so is the original copy will be affected? No. But if you take a copy and modify the things into that, and if you make a Xerox, what happens? Effects will be occurred in the Xerox copy also. So understood? If you make a Xerox copy, call by value. Making the changes to the original copy, call by reference. Simple concept. Clear? So these are the things which are related to call by value and call by reference. To all my viewers and subscribers, I have a small question. What is that? If you want to work out with the swap function, if you want to work out with the swap function, we are calling that swap ampersand A, ampersand B, or normally A comma B. Whatever, it may be call by value, it may be of call by reference. That means if you want to work with one function, we need to call, right? Now the main is also a function. Clear? The main is also a function, but who is calling the main function? Here swap function is we have defined, we are calling here as swap A comma B or ampersand A comma ampersand B. Similarly, main is also a function, but who is calling the main function? So how the main function is called? So where is the calling here? This is called function, this is calling function, right? So this is main function, is no called function. So where is the calling function? Who calls the main function? That is my question. Responses please in the comment section. Clear? Thank you. If you have any doubts in this call by value and call by reference, please comment me in the comment section. And whatever the question I asked, the answer also I expected in the comment section. Thank you.